Okay, we're back here. This is the fifth video of the day. If you notice on part four, it accidentally got cut off at 14 minutes and 33 seconds. And we were striving for about a 19-minute video because I forgot to turn on a calendar reminder came on my appointment book on the BlackBerry. And it seems like every time that happens, the video gets suspended. Yeah. Unfortunately, but we got most of it on there. Shout outs and stuff.
Yeah.
We're gonna do a quick one here because we have some other things we gotta go do. Jeremy's got some things he's gotta handle.
Yeah.
This afternoon, I have some things to do. So we'll do about a 10-minute video here. But we've just been shouting out people, and look, I want to say like our main goal here, you know. People speak to us, you know. We have spirits that will speak to us. And, you know, but our main goal is that we want to teach other people how to do it. You know, that's what we try to do, you know. And the main thing also we try to do is always to get y'all to remember and always know that no one dies. And the main thing you can do, the best thing you can do is change your behavior. So, once you learn how not to be upset when people die, once that becomes something you do naturally, once it totally reverses itself and you're happy when people die, not that you want them to suffer or anything, but you're happy with knowledge of what really happens and how happy they are, then that's a big, your life will change and it will change fast.
Yeah.
I know when death puts a smile on your face, when you're like, when you hear so-and-so died last night and you're celebrating for them, you go get a glass of champagne and you toast for them and you show them love that way instead of, you know, skipping the tears and the weeping. Instead, you're slamming glasses together and toasting their life and toasting their new existence on the other side. I'm not trying to excuse certain ways, killing or anything like that.
Yeah, it's
of course not.
Natural to grieve, we understand all that, you know.
Yeah, but you can surpass that. That's what this is the bottom line out of all of our words, really. And surpass that. We want you to learn how to do that, and we want to teach you all how to do this, you know. How to do that. You know, write something. Try to pick up on what he's talking for me. I just had to write a note about this video.
Yeah, you know, there's ways of dealing with things, you know, like just, you know, that just, you know, are better sometimes in grieving and everything. Like, you know, I've always felt bad for grieving over spirits in the past, you know, because how were they feeling when I was doing all this grieving when they couldn't contact me? You know, or having trouble contacting me, or I wasn't looking, opening up to them, you know.
That's right.
In the past, you know, I've been guilty of that, you know, and I don't want to bring any spirit down either, you know.
That's right.
You know, I got to be more conscious. I beat myself up for being more conscious about how spirits feel, about how I feel, you know. You know, they're only, you know, they're just like us, you know, they're the leaders of their domains too, so
correct.
They can only deal with it so much too, you know. You know, you don't want to put them through a lot of, you know.
You don't want to, they're feeling all your pain. As empathics and telepaths, these spirits are having a hard time. The grief really is hard on them. And they, because like I said, I've taught you all many times, so is Jeremy, that one minuscule thought about someone who's died, it brings them to you, right next to you instantly.
Yeah.
You know? And a happy thought, sad thought, don't matter. I've seen spirits sit there and cry one minute and smile the next just because of people's emotions switching back and forth. And, you know, you're putting them through a lot.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's why we get a lot of them liking to hang out with us when they just crossed over, because there's no sad emotion around us, you know. All it is laughter and happiness and all, like, I mean, we're not saying y'all are doing anything wrong. It's a healing process. But, you know, we make it easy for the spirits to hang with us. And, you know, we make it fun and easy. And we, too, treat them with a lot of kindness, man. You know, I've had some just hang every day, literally every day, all day. You know,
yeah.
Same person, all day, every day. He consistently with me, most of the time, every day. You know, like always with me, always, always sitting in the car next to me, crank, say, Matt, crank the music up, put the bass on, stuff like that. You know, as my riding partner. You know, what can I call it, a riding buddy or something? What's the word for that?
Your, sidekick.
Sidekick, yeah. Yeah, the man of my sidekick. And kind of still is, you know. That's more than one. But, you know, that dude is definitely a sidekick, more than a sidekick. That's my, you call it a ride or die partner, you know.
Yeah.
That's my partner for the, going along for the ride.
Yeah.
You know. By my partner in my work. And, but anyway, though, something else to say, though, too. We got a few minutes left.
He'll be here at one.
So. Yeah, we got a few. We're going to go until he gets here. So Jeremy has a ride coming to pick him up to go to the store.
Yeah.
We just wanted to say, like, one more time, keep the questions coming. We're going to get back to answering questions probably tomorrow. We've gotten some more. And I believe the guy, another guy named Mike wrote me. We have a lot of Mikes, but a guy named Mike wrote, I believe that's his name, asking about your mom or something like that.
Yeah.
And your mom's anniversary of her death is about a month away. We'll handle that for you, you know.
Yeah.
We're going to send you a text message today. We'll probably get to it tomorrow. And tomorrow, the first opportunity to handle it. And I think I see her coming through. I got to see a woman now.
Yeah.
You see her?
Long black hair.
Long black hair, yeah.
Kind of wavy, you know. Yeah, I can see her.
See, she's up. See what we're talking about? She's here already. Mm-hmm. And she wants to come through, answer questions. And to, and Dominique, please don't forget to call us. You know? And same thing goes for the rest of y'all that we called back yesterday. Brandon and Tasha, call us, you know. Anyone we missed, I forgot to mention, pick up that phone call, you know. Don't be afraid to call. You know, a lot of people we know this, you know, might call. So that's why I try to catch y'all when you call first time, you know, because, for people have a chance to think otherwise and worry, should I really be doing this or is this really right?
Please
don't
worry about that.
Don't worry about that. It is okay to do this.
Yeah.
You know, and you're not going to lose anything. You have everything to gain, nothing to lose by doing this. You have a chance to become very knowledgeable and to learn a lot. Let's see, what else can we say? Any other spirits? Let me see if I forgot anybody that I wanted to shout out. Let me see. I see some. We want to say, who's this guy here, man? Forgot his name, man, but I'm seeing a bunch of people. We got to give the shout outs to our Crip and Blood brothers all over the country.
Yeah.
I see, that's what I wanted to say. I see a bunch of them.
Yeah.
You know, the both sides just waving, you know. All our gangbanger friends in the spirit world, one love to you guys, you know. We love every one of y'all, you know. I see all of you. I see you guys right now coming through, you know. And my buddy that I crossed over that time, I see you now too, man. Thanks for saying hello. You know, this is one guy that was a blood gangbanger from South Central LA. He was in a lost and self-imposed exile dimension for about 20 years.
Yeah.
And Todd took him through this winter. He's very happy now.
Right.
He's wearing a big old smile on his face. What's up to Brandon from Southside? To Brandon, and he was very happy. Another one that was self-imposed. And to his cousin, what's his cousin's name? Kanan, right? He had a funny name, Randy JR's friend, Kanan, Randy, and Brandon, you know, they're all from Richmond, you know, I see y'all, you know, and, you know, your people love you, y'all know that, and, you know, y'all are happy to be back together on the other side. Randy JR talks about you guys all the time, especially about Skeety. That's the name I live for, that's his nickname, Skeety. You know, like, but does, if y'all know them, they're all our